and welcome. Hello and welcome to the Alchemist Bride channel. I am the bride, and this is the lab where I will be creating drawing experiments to get better at drawing. I don't have a preview. I'm not sure how I sound, how it looks. I don't even have a Photoshop screen up here, but I'm hoping it works. Let me find my screen. Here we go. Maybe it doesn't like how big this file is. This is getting to be a very big file. What I managed to do after the last stream, last time on the Alchemist Bride, I started the comic that I said I was training on, and now I laid it out. So you saw last time that I laid out the first issue, and I started on the second issue. And I think my plan is to lay out the first six issues and then go back and kind of ink them all at once. That's the plan. We'll see how much I get through. I'm still not totally convinced. Let's see if this works. Oh, good. All right, I have a mouse. I'm not totally convinced. Get my glove on. I made breakfast. I didn't eat it. I am not ready, but here we go. I'm not completely sold on what I did for the second comic. Some of this stuff keeps me up at night, but let's review it. I haven't looked at it in a while. All right, so this is what I'm talking about. So then on this file, I digress. I made these artboards. So this is what you saw me work on last week. I spent most of the time up here on this palace, right? And then I worked my way down, and I added where the dialogue and script is going to go, but I didn't add the dialogue itself, right? So I just blocked it in, which was my plan for the second one, except the second one has so much dialogue. I mean, this has quite a bit of dialogue too. This one doesn't have dialogue as much as it has, crunchy bag again. Like explanations, so there's just explanation boxes. And when you have explanation boxes, they can kind of go everywhere. They don't have to be associated with where the character is positioned, I don't think, as much. So this is as far as I got. Main reveal of the love interest, and then the end. So I got to the end of this, started playing with it, and moved on to just adding artboards to the same file and sketching it out. So this is what you didn't see I worked in the meantime. This is now issue two. So this is a callback. Here's a marketplace, which I brought up the art for last time. Just a minute. I don't know why I don't have a preview. It says it's live. It says it's excellent, but it's also showing me offline. I don't understand. I'm hoping you can see me. Yeah, it says I'm live. Usually I have a little, oh, there it is. It came on. Great. Good. I was getting worried. Where's my... All right. We're good now. So last week I worked on this. Pulled out the marketplace art that you had seen prior to before. Sidebar. I did change up the music, so hopefully you can hear me a lot better. When I saw on playback last week, because I take the video and download it and stuff after. Because like I said, I like to film while I'm drawing it, because if I make a mistake, I can go back and reference it or figure out how I did it. If I'm using tricks or if I need the brushes or whatever it is, I can look and see kind of compare to it. So I keep the video. But anyway, so when I was listening back to the video, the music was quite loud, and somebody did bring that up. So I think I fixed it this week. I was kind of listening to it and playing with it. So hopefully I fixed it. Hopefully you can hear me. If not, just jam out and enjoy the art while I kind of muffle through explaining it. So anyway, the marketplace art that I referenced, I did switch it up quite a bit. Like I said, I watched Avatar The Last Airbender, and I like the scene when they're fighting in Omashu and just how that marketplace looks. That's how I want my marketplace to look, so that's what I'm going for. So I just made it a little tighter, but it does look quite a bit like the original one. And you can see the main character. She's right here. I'll take you through the flow of that. We'll get you all caught up here. Let's see. Okay, so here's this. She's right here. That's the main character, and then it zooms in on her here. So the zoom zoom from the prior issue, the bird, showed up before, and now, obviously, it's her friend. She's still in the marketplace. But she's basically, so she's in the marketplace, shouting, "Hey, come buy my stuff." And then she notices that she's got a scratch. Oh my goodness. And then, lo and behold, somebody walks in. She's like, ooh. Basically, she thinks she has a mark. She's like, okay, he looks like he has some money. I'm gonna get with that. And then she, see, he's kind of cute. She even acknowledges, like, huh, not bad. Not bad walking through here. He looks totally out of place, though. Like, he looks lost. Okay, so anyway, she calls him out, you know, tries to get him to, like, buy something. Because, like I said, she's a businesswoman and an entrepreneur and a trying to make it happen. And he's like, I'm not looking for something. You know, I'm looking for someone. And little does she realize he's actually after her and has ambitions for her. So anyway, they go through all this. And he, like, reveals he knows her name. She's like, oh, no, freaking out. Like, how do you know my name? And he starts to explain himself, like, oh, yeah, you know, I want a partnership with you. And she's like, okay, I've heard that before, whatever. And, you know, come work with me. She's like, no, because, again, he's from a warring nation. He's from a, like, it's like a war between their two nations was fairly recent. They're not in war right now, but they certainly are cautious. There's still pirating and stuff going on. So anyway, he mentions where he's from. She's like, that's a red flag. There's no way I'm going with you. Like, who does this guy think he is? She's not looking defect. Like, get out of here. Go recruit somewhere else. And she's like, yeah, it's time for you to go. As I'm looking back on this, I actually do like how this flows. Okay, so then zoom zoom here intervenes. This is actually my favorite part in the whole issue. The bird's like, squawk, get out of here. And I even like his expression here. Again, my sketches are very, very rough. And he's like, all right, I don't want to trouble you anymore. I'm out of here. But basically, like, I'll see you again. So lo and behold, somebody comes in, like, tries to take her stuff. And she's like, what are you doing with my stuff? What are you talking about? And he's like, oh, your husband sent us. And she's like, what husband? And then right here, hands over the documentation. They're slick forgers over at BSC. And then she starts to explain this is Benyus's alchemy journal, and it's gonna pop in throughout the book, explaining some of the lore, because this is important. So, you know, it talks about the company, Big Sales Enterprises, and where it's like, it's in Verilay, like I said, and so, you know, but BSC is known for, you know, snatching up little merchants and then stealing all their stuff and basically just like eating up intellectual property. Okay. And she's like an independent, not artist, but creator, inventor, entrepreneur of her own, like I said. So, you know, she's like, oh, okay, he thinks that if he marries me, he's gonna get his hands on my stuff. Well, I'm not gonna let that happen, right? So she is like, oh yeah, of course, you know, don't worry about it. He didn't realize I was still working today. Like, come back tomorrow, I'll be ready. And then they're like, no, he told us to come. And she's like, no, listen, you work for me now, thinking on the fly, like, I'm his wife, you need to go. And they're like, oh, okay, so they're out. Then that evening, you know, she's out of here. Benyus is officially on the run. She's like, I'll make sure of it. They're never going to get my work. Like, I might have to put more dialogue in here about, like, she, you know, I don't know, something about Damien in here or something. Like, maybe instead of, I'll make sure of it, like, marriage or not. I don't know. I'm still kind of thinking about that. But anyway, so this is issue two. I think I still like it, actually. Hopefully, let me know if you think it flows or doesn't flow. I'm going to stand by it. I won't know anything until I really go to draw it, but I think as far as layouts goes, it's pretty good. So I'm gonna leave this one alone. Just gonna lock that layer. You can see over here, when you create artboards, or maybe not, maybe it wasn't the artboards I created, but I created folders based on the artboards. So these are the different issues, so I can lock them. So if I do a select all or something, I won't lose my stuff. Okay, so which brings us over here, new blank slate. This is issue 3 now. So she escapes, and where we left off in issue 1. So that entire scene was a flashback, right, over here. This whole thing, you know, several months ago. And this whole, so it basically just like goes back to their, you know, first meeting. I'm starting to wonder if I should add another panel that like has her back. Yeah. Real quick. I don't want to make this. How can I move that? It's not. Hang on. Oh. Silly me, it is. Okay. I'm gonna move this whole thing down. Which is fine. I have room anyway. Like a little bit of room. Maybe. So I really like her expression here. Maybe she'll say something like, or so I thought. Like, they'll never find me. So I think, actually, I'm just gonna like, even a little smaller than that. Again, like I said, I tend to draw things really big and have to scale them down. It's just something I do. Which is what I was thinking I would have to do in here, but I actually kind of like it. I think it turned out okay. This is also my second favorite part here. Again, the part with the bird. Zoom Zoom's just on her head. They're both giving him like a get out of here kind of face, but like Zoom Zoom's expression right here, where I don't know if you could see, he's like mad. I think it's really funny. It amuses me. Zoom Zoom is the best. So if all goes according to plan, there will be a Zoom Zoom plushie in the future. Mostly just because I want one. So anyway, I'm going to add maybe like a... I don't know what she should say here. Oh, they'll never get their hands on my work. Make sure that, like, they'll never see me again. I think, or so I thought, I'm not going to get too worried about it. This is not going to be like the Iliad and the Odyssey. If we do if I get rid of all this, I'm going to change her facial expression. What's her hair like? Oh wait, I know. Do do do. I did her volume. Okay, I'm gonna steal this. I'll just put it here. Where did I put it? Oh, okay, great. Down. Look at how long this thing is. Like, this actually does kind of take a long time to read through. I'm just gonna put that there for my own reference. Okay, there's gonna be a lot of bouncing around. Whoops. So I think I'll have just one more panel where she's like, oh, or so I thought. In like a present day. What I really wanted to do is go back to kind of where he comes in, but a present day. or now. It's not really present day because it's all dated and there is a bit of... Or so... Or maybe I'll go somewhere where they'll never find me. Yeah, that makes more sense. They'll never find me again. That makes more sense, because, like, she sort of becomes a, Maybe just, they'll never find me. Because they'll never find me. She really thought she could run, though. Again, this is a big company. Maybe this is where she says I'll make sure of it. It's kind of, I have to get this out of the way because this stuff keeps me up. Goes here. Because I actually really like her hood there. Boom, boom. Alright, there's the top bubble. Sure of it. I don't know if there's enough room here. Steal Damien from over here. Here we go. Okay. Maybe it's like a side by side. I gotta think about this. Because I want it to lead right into the next issue, right? Actually, this shouldn't even be a thought bubble at all. Because this is probably... this kind of thing. Because she's narrating. You know, now she's... Actually, this... Or so I thought. We were here. Maybe we just... I'm gonna steal this again. Screen capture. Oh no, come back, screen capture! When you're not fast enough, it goes away. Yeah, I like this a lot better. Now it leads into the next issue. Okay, great. Great, crisis averted. the drink I'm sponsored by today is a green tea made by Chin Chin. I'm not sponsored. I sponsored in the way I bought it. I bought it and I'm drinking it. And I do like this one. It doesn't have a ton of sugar. Which I'm not... Oh, yeah, I forgot how good that is. I'm not against sugar in drinks, but sometimes they're just too sweet, especially in teas. So, anyway, if you're wondering what I'm drinking today, and also water. So good. Okay. All right, so we have, now that I got that out of the way, I'm just gonna crop this. I think I want to do a side by side. It's like uncomfortable. Huh. What happened? What's happening here? Why does this happen? It says, okay, I just want to explain what I'm looking at because for my review, it says live feed, excellent, which is great. But for me, the feedback is choppy. So I'm just checking to make sure it's working. What a mess. Okay, let me... steal these guys. I don't like a lot of layers. I like to keep my layers very tight, so... She doesn't have this dialogue anymore. It's just her. This whole thing is smaller. Oh, you know what? This, or so I thought, should go, like, here. No. I don't know. Maybe just a little higher. Layout, honestly, for me, is the battle. Once the layout's there, the drawing part is, you know, more automatic. I think I just want to have them in, like, frames. Like She's like too angled. Too angly. I actually want her on an angle. It's like a, now what? Actually, if anything, one letter. I don't love doing typesetting in Photoshop. I'll say that. Do not care for it. Hold this on. Oh, my clear. Great. Now that that's fixed. Actually, I can move all this down. I think this will be a lot better. And I can fix it too in the final one. But I like to have the sketch be pretty close to what the layout will be, but there's a chance I'll give it some more space. Doshio moment. Doshio, what should I do? I think that makes a lot more sense to let you know you're not him. This'll fade. So, she has her, or so I thought. Oh, this should be one line, or so I thought. That'll fix it. My text is not straight. always go up. Thank goodness for rulers. Oh yeah. Rulers are the best. Maybe this should be what now? Again, this wasn't going to be a writing stream, but... I'm going to leave it. And we're going to get into issue 3. I think this tells the story pretty... clearly sums it right back up, puts them back in the present, at least their present. I'm saying this is a galaxy far, far away. This is definitely pre-technology. It's not steampunk. It's not steampunk, but it's also not... colonial? I don't know if that's the right word. Like, they have cities and stuff. Maybe like Renaissance era, but it's like there's also magic and stuff too. So, suspension of disbelief, but there's not like technically technology. Although the two of these characters would be the closest to what they have technology wise. So she's got potions and spices and can create, you know. Medicinal cures and wards against evil. At least that's her goal. And she created Zoom Zoom, so she has some mechanical ability. So that's why I say there's some steampunk, because they're still like clockwork, you know? But they also use magic, so it's not so much like steam power in their airships. Like, it'll be... I mean, and there is that too, but there'll be like skyships, but they're magical, so... or at least partially magical. Which they'll get into in the next couple issues. Here we'll find out what Damien's deal is. Why would he pluck a country bumpkin out of the a warring nation to marry her? That's weird. Okay, I actually think I want to open with... I want to go back to what I made here. Because that's what mangas do, you know? They always do that stuff. Like, it's everybody back on the same page. Where is it? No? Come in here. Where are you? Here it is. Okay. I don't know where it's copy and pasting into. I'm moving around a lot, sorry. I'm sure it's drawn. So she's like, now what? Okay. The dinner is on. They're in the ballroom again. I guess I'll go back and reference this ballroom, like I said. This is also why I have them all in the same file, so I can jump around fairly easily. Yeah. And reference what I did. So here's the ballroom again. I guess I need all of this just to kind of look at it. Long that is. It is very, very long. Lots of some here just to look at. So in my script, at least as it is, I don't know. she's kind of coming to terms with the fact, like, oh my gosh, he's here. What do I do? She might be sitting at the table. I'm gonna need the wide shot again, just to show where they're at. Maybe he takes his seat at the table. Yeah, that makes sense. Let's do... Excuse me. We have the big perch. Let me figure out where my ground plan is. This perspective. I gotta think about how, I don't know what to do with this right now either. I gotta think about how, I want to show her reacting. Where do I want her to be? Maybe he should just enter. Once they start talking, it's fine, but establishing the setup, I'm not totally sure right now. Let me think. This is actually one of my favorite parts of the whole comic. Is him finding her and explaining himself. Explain yourself. What the heck? Explain yourself. I'm just making some room for myself so I can reference my own stuff. Not really. Put that there. No, I have to. I'll make room. I'm not sure why I'm froggy. Not interested in having a cold of any kind, though they are going around. So, okay, she's like, I actually started putting it in here just because there was so much text. This is, I don't want to say severe language, but adult language at this point. She does have some swears. This ba-dum ba-dum is a note for me. My script, by the way, not like a typical, like, oh, this is a script. I need to make this, like, this is like a, this is a sound effect here. Her heartbeat's going really fast. Oh, and then she goes, yeah. Okay, I'm just reviewing this for myself. She does go into a, she drinks wine after wine, so maybe that's what I'll get into down here. This is kind of funny. It's supposed to be a funny sequence anyway of her just, like, drinking kind of to forget. What do I do? Like, she's nervous, like, nervous drinking. So it's gonna be like, I might need a reference for this. Um, I don't want to do this. Is just, she's like spinning out. She's having, you know, maybe this is her cover. There's guards. Maybe he didn't see me. Just calm down. Like, she's having like a lot of internal dialogue. Let me see if I can find a good reference for somebody drinking wine. I should say chugging wine. That would help my search. Help me. That's a funny picture. Give me a sec. Give me a second. It's kind of like this. Kind of thing. I like this one. I really like her face and the perspective. And I like this one. I think this is kind of the sequence I'm gonna go in, just for reference purposes. So let me line these up. Because I feel like this is the end one, right? Funny. I'm gonna use the whole thing. Something like this. Two, but I like the three. I do. She's definitely funny. There's a humor to her. To her reactions and stuff. That's not the same. Yeah. I don't know if these are celebrities or who they are. These kind of look like memes. Thank you for your sacrifice. The wine ladies. Okay, so here she's like, all right, so first, before I get into that, exits are this hole. Spills on her dress. I'm gonna put this down here so I remember. I feel like the first issue flowed so easily, and I feel like, no, I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, so and this dump it out. It's like happening all through here too. It's like intense. Again, this is a lot of her internal dialogue. Like her heart. Her heart's being really fast. Maybe I make this easy on myself. Oops. Steal this. just... Yeah, I think I'll have him, like, taking a seat or something. Ooh, I didn't even do that, actually. I mean, I did, but... Again, for reference. Where did I have her sitting? That's what I have to figure out. She was sitting... Like, oh, because she is here. She's in the background here. Like, oh, excuse me. Sorry. I'm here. I don't know if I can see. This is her here. She's saying, excuse me, sorry. In the first panel. So whatever. The table. It's like somewhere in the middle. She's like by the stage. So I just want to make sure you can see her table. Probably like here. This is probably her table. I had a guess. Yeah, because, okay, and then here's the stage. So she's sitting here. This is her. But I want to zoom in a lot more. I need a switch angle, is what I'm seeing. Maybe I can find a picture that has the depth that I want. Let's see. Because I feel like she needs to be a little bit more, I don't know, eye level with Damien. Just guessing. And I might need to move. I'm gonna leave them for now. They're fine. So we have a high table. Let me see. The high table. She's sitting up on a platform. How many people I had sitting there. We gotta go stroll over here. Find that out. Come down. Okay. Well, I didn't really say. But you're only gonna see. Wow. That is zoomed in pretty much all the way. But yeah, look at them squares. Alright, I better... I need like a wedding from the angle of, you know, a guest. Zoom out. Oh boy! Alright. Difficult, difficult. Alright, so... It might help me to pull up my ballroom just reference to look at it. That's one of them. This is before I made square tables. This is the one I used. I like this angle a lot. Maybe a wide angle like this. Go here. And it's just really, you'll see really small, like he comes in. That might work. Instead of what I was doing, which was whatever this is. Ba-dump. Oh, my sneeze. I hope that doesn't mean I'm catching a cold. I don't have time. I actively just don't have time. I want to do this. I want to do my other stuff. I think I will. Use the, well. Yeah, because there's a dome. That's what I just have to keep in mind what I changed. This is all brown. This is a dome now. So I'm gonna focus on the drawing. So I think I had, let's say, 8 tables. Here's the hen table. And again, trying to be consistent. Let's look at what I did before. Background is the same. Maybe I haven't decided on it yet, so it doesn't really matter. I think I just put it in there and I was going to add, make sure there's a dome. So. You know. There's a center line here. Here. Cool. Dome taking. That's pillars. I think maybe, let me look at this real quick. I just want to see if I kind of decorated it the same way from all the angles. I did. Except if I wanted big arches, which I don't have on this angle. Just look at it real quick. Yes. Oh, okay. Yep. No, I left it out. Alright. In the original, they're supposed to be... This is taller. So we go make a note real quick. Do-do-do. Sorry for the scrolling. Something like that. I'm just reminding myself I have to put an arch or not an arch. I have to decide what it looks like. Just need to know. There it is. I went right past it. Okay. An hour in and only 2 panels. So we have the head table with the empress on her throne. Really small. Like Damien's gonna walk in. This is Damien. Walking in confident. feels good. Maybe somebody else. Would be obviously be decorations and stuff here. Let's see. Right on the end. Perfect. Now, alright, so I can see here. I'm gonna put in the perspective lines. Something like this, I can kind of see them. Point of origin is up here, or vanishing point, I should say. So, like I said, there's 8 tables. This is the center. You're not quite right. Let's see what we get. So I wanted 8. Where did I say this is center? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I know it looks really sloppy. I'm gonna fix it. I didn't make that great. You should be firm. You should be firm decisions here. Let me fix this. Yeah. I'm gonna use my trick. I'm gonna use my actual ruler. Here's my vanishing point. Here, up here. Using rulers because I don't know a way. In Illustrator you can draw a straight line, but in Photoshop I would have to like create a line and then. Well, maybe I'm doing this wrong. There's a way to do it in Photoshop too. I just don't know. I'm not a Photoshop expert. I just like drawing. How do we come to about here? I'll probably end. No, they're longer. So like long, elegant tables. I do sense a little sniffle. That's unfortunate. Could be the weather. Not gonna worry about it. I feel okay right now. Next week might be a snot show, though. Just saying. Probably all the way to the edge of the stage. Okay. Space is not consistent between them. I will fix that. I like how it looks, though. They're just not totally in the right places yet. These need to be kind of... Well, that's weird. Alright. It's weird because I expected them to line up. I mean, the tables are very big, but the scale, you know, figure it is. 6 guests on each side. That's what I'm figuring anyway. I'm not sure, but that's what I'm figuring. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm glad I'm not doing the circular tables anymore, though. These actually make more sense. I think they're a little bit more elegant. Be at that high rate. Actually, they're magical. They should just float. They shouldn't even have legs. Then none of the guests would bump their knees. Bumping knees into the table is the worst. Then you shake the whole table too, knock over people's drinks. It's a whole mess. I think that feels a little more better. More better. It's better than better. It's more. Yeah, for now, sure. Like I said, I just needed to get it in. Chairs on this side too. Okay, so he walks in, she's sitting about here. Make her good. She stands up, she's about this high, so just sit about here. In fact, I'm not using color in this, but if I was, and maybe I will use instances of color to make points like this, I would isolate her. So maybe I'll make everything around her kind of dark and isolate just her. First issue. Let's see. I don't think. Yeah, I didn't have multiple depth. I didn't know if there was a second row, but I don't think there's a second row, so I'm not going to put it in based on the first issue. I mean, this is mammoth sized. This is why I was sketching it all out, so I could make sure the consistency, that the canon is intact. There were two stained glass windows in the first panel. I'm a human. I'm telling you right now, it's not going to be a perfect comic. But I do like parts of it. I'm not into backgrounds. You could see that struggle last year if you missed it on the stream. I mean, I was learning perspective and how to even do these buildings, and it was a mess. I am not an architect person. I spent a long time just trying to design the one palace to figure out where this space would be. I really just want to draw the characters, but the setting's really important, so I'm trying to make sure that the setting is good. Good enough. I do want it to be really good, though. I am trying. I feel like sometimes... What is on this layer? Oh, them. Yes. The wine ladies. I forgot. Okay, I'll be for them in a second. I can't wait to get to them. All right, so this is more heartbeat stuff. All right, so I'm going to bring bits of all this dialogue that I had. This has to go in here. I know the person puts this as speaking. So I have to figure out how to break this up to flow through the panel. Maybe I don't need this ba-dump yet. Ba-dump, ba-dump, ba-dump. This is more of her dialogue. Oh, because she's out of her feet. Yeah. No. See me now if she's here. Just blocking it in. Here. Did he track me here? Here. Okay. Again, the typesetting is like kind of the last thing I'll be doing. I just want to make sure it has a place to be before I do a bunch of drawing around it. This, I think. This I'm going to put into. This is my handwriting. I think I'm going to break this up. This is boring. I know. I feel like in some ways the palace was more entertaining. Or less boring. The palace was more entertaining. What did I just say? I don't remember. Onomatopoeia. Yeah, this is the... Where am I? Alright, so now this is where she has her wine meltdown. Wine meltdown alert! Pew pew! I've never spill on her dress. Actually pretty curved. That she just have long red nails. The wine glass. The very fancy magical wine glass. She's thinking. This is like a passage of time thing too, and I should look up. I have the Making Comics. Yeah, yeah. I have been reviewing this. It's called Making Comics by Scott McCloud, and it just talks about there's a section, and it might be in the other book, Understanding Comics. They talk about pacing. So let me just look really quick, because what I want to be able to do is the passage of time, and I know he talks about it. Maybe there's an index. The passage of time. Pacing? Maybe it's pacing. Moment to moment. Okay, so it's pretty early. That makes sense, because... But my point is, this is going to be a kind of like she's drinking, like this is like one glass, and then her like next glass. So many wine glass. She's not gonna down the whole bottle. Though that'd be funny. I want to get it so that she's like starts to swim around the eyes a little bit. Like she's thinking, but she's also drinking. And again, she's just nervous. She thought she'd outrun him. The bottle at the end would be very funny. Would really be very funny. Let's see. Using reference, I mean, it doesn't change a lot. wine glass. It's really weird. Oh, yeah, she should be looking down. Like, again, she's kind of thinking through it all. Drinking's hard to draw, especially if you've been drinking. Cut that, but I need the room for my mom. Alright, that's all done. Maybe I'll have a little, like, how many was there? How many glasses was there? Like a little dizzy than yesterday or... Maybe I do. Maybe I move this ba-dump here. So sloppy. Ruffs. Somewhere. was this year? How many glasses was that? The little one. Boop, boop. Maybe I don't need boxes. Maybe it can just be like text. Maybe I'll just write the text like over them. So maybe this. Maybe this will just, I'll just plan on having text like above this. And I need a reference for somebody spilling on their dress. Let's see what we get. Oh yeah, actually this is pretty good. Coffee on her dress. Bummer. I like that. And she's gonna spill on her dress, he said. Man, I'm not even on the, this is still the first paragraph of my script. My gosh. Know how to. I more wanted this for the pose, not for the expression. The pose. She, again, having a total, absolute freak out. All the forks. I'll have to look up what a full table setting looks like. This will be all the forks. Oh, they've got their flowers on the table and stuff. It's the full table setting. I'm supposed to be feeling real bad for her. You know, she's kind of. There's like a gentleman next to her, like, what's happening? Her dress back. It's funny because in the first issue she's bragging about how she got this fancy dress for it, so. Oh no, my dress. Calm down. Actually, I'll bring it further back to you. I'll put them in the reference folder up here. Oops. Up here. Oh, you want it? That's so weird. Why don't you go in this folder? I don't understand. Making some progress now. The plot moves forward. So she starts to lose hope. I do think, like, she should say, maybe he didn't see me down here. And then he asks her to dance, which is where the real magic happens. Okay. So he's like, hey, whoops. Put this is, again, the layout with the text and the overlay and her thoughts and his thoughts and like a dialogue and him interrupting. Maybe this goes here. I don't know. Again, my sketches are super sloppy. Never seen me draw before. They look like nonsense, and then when I'm finished, it's like, oh, those are complete thoughts. Where is this layer? Ah, I see. You should not be on this layer. This whole layer should be locked. You shouldn't even see that layer right now. Oh, there was more. Anyway. Okay, back to my sketch. It's over here. And then, you know, maybe you didn't see me. She's talking to herself, so I can't decide if it's maybe he didn't even see you. Like, calm down, Vanessa. Maybe he didn't even see you, but she's talking to herself. I think I'm gonna make it you, since she's talking to herself, and then he's like, right here, this piece of dialogue. Major point in the story. mean, I have the script sitting here, but drawing it, it's a little different. I've already cut something out. I really wanted her to be like, ooh, dessert. Maybe I'll put it here. I'll put it here. Because it is supposed to be a cutesy, like, internal dialogue thing. So she'll be like, ooh, is that dessert? And then this up here. She's like, shit. I'm in trouble. I'm in trouble. Watch out. Okay. I do like this. This is flowing pretty well. I'm gonna scoot this over and make it smaller either way so it's not on the edge. That way, now that this guy's who's sitting here, you know, he's just like a shadow of a poof. He'll just be completely, blocked out. Because the focus will absolutely 100% be on her. Like I said, just like with this panel too, like she's here. Oh no! Wait, is he on here? Where'd my Damien go? Did I delete him? Oh. See? I can find it later, but I'm pretty sure I can just draw it real quick. Unbelievable. It's fine. This is just a rough. So he was walking in, going to take his seat. I already made him too big. So here's his little cape. Here's the Empress, like, hey, come on. We weren't all waiting for you, but you were late, dude. Take your seat. Here's a person. Here's his seat. She doesn't have a head table. They're mostly just her court. And then here's Vanessa. So I remember for later. When I try to make sense of all of this, like, scribbleness. Because I know it's scribbled. I love this sequence. I think this looks really cool. Great. High energy. It's supposed to be panicky. Gosh, a lot of this. Just really kind of... Everything's a little off kilter. Although, I don't know how I got so off center here. These are way not where they're supposed to be. Did everything move? Oh, no, the whole comic moved. Okay. Let's put it all back. Yeah, the whole thing went off center. Good enough. Oh, and moved down. Great. I would lock it if I wasn't working on it. That's why these guys are locked. So I don't accidentally delete a bunch of important stuff. It happens, though. This is why I record. I'm not sure. Okay, so... I think I'm gonna cut just a little bit. I had a lot of like her panicking stuff, so she's like, this is a good time to call it a night, like, oh, dessert and blah 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 and all this stuff. But I think where she's like, oh, maybe he didn't even see you, is when he intervenes, like, my dear. And then I feel like I'm not sure what the turn is. Maybe it goes to him? And kind of a clip of her, like here. Yeah, we're just gonna assume the music's been playing this whole time and she's completely been in her own head. I wonder if I can find a reference for taking somebody's, like, hand. You're reaching out. Let's see. Reaching out reference? I don't think I'll find the... Ooh, I like that hand. Ooh! This is a good one, actually. Oh, I like when that works out. Oh, I like that a lot. Yeah. He's reaching out. Just this. Oh. You're on the wrong layer. Happens all the time. If you like me, I can't remember what the poofy sleeves are called now, but I used to know the term. I'll think of it. Hey girl. Let's dance. That's not the line. That's not the line. Oh, that'd be funny for me. Let's see how this looks. Without the reference. So I want him to be reaching kind of towards her. That's what I like about it. It's a little bigger. No, it's too big. And he's like, hey, come dance with me. Sloppy, raccoon. I actually just really like drawing him though, because, like I said, I love him. I love him, I love Zuko. I love him, I love Zuko, I love Garrus, I love Lloyd, Voyager, I love Tuxedo Mask, and I love Damian Alexander. Those are my husbandos. Delightful. And if somebody ever cosplays Damian Alexander and I am at a comic book show, I'm not doing comic book shows right now, but if I do them again, and somebody comes up to me and cosplays Damian Alexander, I will openly weep. And then I will just, like, make them stand next to me the whole time so I can pet the poofy sleeve. I can't think of what it's called right now, but if you're okay with that, come, go ahead, cosplay. Cosplay as Damian, just to see what I'll do. I mean, I saw Prince Eric at Disney, which is like, it doesn't look like Damian, and he wasn't inspired by Damian, but when I saw Prince Eric at Disney, I was like, oh my god, he kind of reminds me of Damian. And his arm was seriously like this big, and I was like, I don't know, I mean, it's just, I know they're, like, it was like the A... Like the A Prince Eric, the A Ariel, the A Prince Eric, and I was like speechless. I was like, hi. So I can't even imagine what, like, Damian Alexander. When he dressed up like, I don't know. Also, a very expensive costume though, so. Go ahead. He's so happy to see her. He's like. And it's also like, I kind of got you. Like, I got you. You thought you ran. You're so clever. But lucky me, I found you. I really hope I can draw him semi-consistently. I feel like I draw him and her. I switch up how I draw them. For her, it doesn't matter so much because she's so expressive, so I don't mind changing the style. But for him, I honestly just wanted to be that, like, stoic. You know, I don't even know what to... That's probably a term for it. I don't read enough. I do read manga, but I don't read enough manga to know, like, exactly what they reference it as. Just, like, kind of, like, beautiful stare. Yeah, maybe this continues so you know it's him talking. Alright. Man, I found that pose right away. That was great. Very, very helpful. Thanks, internet. Yeah. Because I said reaching out, and I thought it would be more like this. I thought I was going to get references like this. I didn't think I'd get one so close to what I got, so that's excellent. Very helpful. It makes it a little faster. I never trace. I don't trace. Not typically. Unless I'm really trying to learn something very specific, but I usually just... look at it. Oh, no, he says, my dear wife. And he says it several times, and I can hear it rent-free in my mind. My dear Wood. Look, if you're not gonna love your characters, who will? So he's like, allow me the pleasure of this dance. Oh, and she has more funny internal dialogue. She's had enough wine, she thinks he looks good again. Because remember, she thought he was cute when she saw him in the marketplace. She's like, oh, he's kind of cute. You're not wrong, Vinyasa. If I didn't mention it, this is my handwriting. I made like a font out of my handwriting. I don't know if I'll use for the whole time. Probably. I probably will. Or at least I'll type it and then write over it to make it look a little bit more natural. Because I don't mind writing text. I think letter setting is really cool. But placing it is really annoying. So if I can have it just to trace over, that's probably what I'll end up doing. Hopefully that works. He's like, hey, my pleasure with this dance. And she's like, oh my god, what? Yeah, I think down here. Got this. Sorry, it keeps slipping. I'm sure that's jarring to look at on the screen. Sorry. It just goes. I don't know if that's a setting I can fix. If it is, I'll fix it. Nice. Another text box. Again, I don't particularly like doing text in Photoshop. But for this, I did want to, because he does do some shady things. Last stream, one of the viewers called him a bad boy. I don't think he's a bad boy, but he certainly has some techniques that are questionable, particularly early on. Later on, he straightens up, you guys. Does that work out for him? Can't tell you. This can be a thought bubble. Just a little too low. Okay. That was nice. Okay. So then we'll have her here. Just reacting to him, really. Here. Boy. This is where we found out if I can draw. Some hair like hairline, strands. Gotta figure out where her face and eyebrows are. I still want you to see her. Trying to look at him, which normally, like in real life, you probably wouldn't see your eyes, but maybe a lot closer. Yeah, like that. So now she gets kind of snappy with him, right? So he comes over, he's all like, hey. Yeah, I think maybe I'll do something. I don't know what I'll... I gotta show passage of time, but I'm gonna make sure time passes here. I'm not sure how yet. I'll figure that out. But mostly, you're gonna get... It's not one... This isn't one glass of wine. This is over the course of dinner, basically. Because she's like, oh, how many glasses is that? Ooh, is that dessert? Oh, no, I spilled. Like, calm down. He didn't see you. Do-do-do. And then we get here. And how did she get here mode? So. What's that? He reaches out. I don't love this line here. Alright, so she gets mad. Actually, I think this is going to be just like a... start to break out a little bit. Maybe she'll just be like in her own box. She's like, oh, are you giving me a choice? I don't know. Yeah, I don't like that line, so maybe I'll like it lower. Or down. Here comes forward. If there is a guy here that she was sitting next to, I better put him in. He kind of leans in, you know. People taking the floor. I don't know. I'll figure that out. Don't hold me to it. Don't hold me to any of this. This is a project in progress. Oh, we can maybe. So this is more palace reference, so I'll just keep moving this down so I can keep opening it. Oh, that's where it is! Found it. The thing that I deleted. Here. Which basically, like I said, exactly the same. Good for me! Was able to redraw it, no problem. So, that's fine. I will make a note though. So I remember this is doing it. Because I don't know when, like I said, I'm laying out 6 issues kind of in a row. I'm not sure when I'll actually get to drawing this, so making notes to myself in the rough is going to be really important, I feel like. Alright, so he's like, dance with me. She's like, how about no? I'm like, come on. Although I think this is all too good. Oh yeah, this should be rounder. I mean, I'm gonna fix it, but it's nice to have the reference be kind of right. So she's mad. Actually, she'll be wiping off her her stain. Okay, you give me a choice. She's still seated. Let's see where the table will be. What's my perspective gonna be? At the ground, so. Chair. He's standing. Because if she was standing, she'd be like here. So if he's standing, he'd be like here. Yeah, that feels pretty good. guessing. But if this is the ground plane, hear me out. If this is the ground plane, if she stood up here, she'd be like this tall. She'd be like here. So this is all coming. Oh, look at that! I lined it up. See that? Because if they were standing here, they'd be this tall. Mm-hmm. Respect. Ish enough. Enough to be believable. It's a hinge kind of on the same part. So, anyway. He's like, come on. No, really. Like this. It's not going to be wasted. So that I can... I think he's too big. He's too big. Like I said, she's kind of mad about it. She's like, are you giving me a choice? Because she got served with marriage documents last time they were together. Or where they weren't together. He wasn't even there for it. So, let's steal this. And then her little inner voice is over here, like, yeah, you tell him. Smaller though. Alright, so I see that I'm on the wrong layer, but I don't know what else is on this. Whoops, I don't know what else is on this layer, so let's find out. Oh, just that. That's fine. Oh, good. Oh, yeah, for sure. And then he explains himself. I've never read a note, wiping her stain. This is like a lot of moving. And he's like, this is this. Over. Boring stuff. Type settings boring. Sorry, I know the character stuff is way more exciting. I know it. More exciting for me too. If you want to lay this out? So sloppy. And then I kind of just want them to have a stare off. So I want to steal this. Make it look a little bigger. So the line quality is smaller. He might remember this face from the marketplace when she told him to get lost. So she will have internal dialogue again going here, weighing her options. You know, she doesn't want to make a scene, right? She's trying to still make deals. So here's where she's at. Internal dialogue. I feel like it gives such an insight to the character. It lets you get to know them a lot better. So. Now she's thinking if she starts a scene here and doesn't dance with them and he gets mean about it, that, you know, she'll be like shunned a little. So she's a little worried, because again, big company, a lot of reach. Again, I like to keep my layers nice and minimal. Minimal layers. Oh, she's like here. I'm gonna do that. Then she's like, fine, I'll dance. All right, final dance. Fine. But he was like, let's discuss. And she's like, I don't want to discuss anything. I'm not talking to you. The reason I'm adding, like I said, I like to keep the layers minimal, but this is also just a sketch and I'm not worried about having to edit the layers later. I think if I was really typesetting it, I would leave the letters and let them be editable. So fine, I'll dance. So now, okay, now I need my ballroom again for my wide shot. That might be too wide though for what I want. Let me think about it. Again, these are drawings that I did last year on the stream when I was preparing to do this pen. Maybe this one. Oh, I did fancy him up for this. I forgot. He doesn't have the poofy sleeves. I think I'm going to keep him. Do I fancy him up? I'll decide later. Okay, so this angle. This is the angle I want, but I want it a lot closer in. Let me think about how I want this. Be like that. Pull this in. It's here. Okay, so let's say the stage is here. What? Hang on, I have to see really quick what this is. Okay, that's that. Okay, this is this, okay. Here, all right. And then I'm gonna move my palace down so I can look at it. Oh, it's not even here anymore. Yeah, let me pull it again. Let me find my palace. What I'm referencing anyway. Okay. So. And this has like really big. I'm gonna put them here. Okay. Here's the. I've got it. Well, let me look. Okay. The state. Okay. The stage comes out like this. What they're on. Yeah, just the platform that the table sits on, like this kind of thing. This is the vanishing point right here. So everything is gonna look kind of flat. The table probably goes like here. If this is the center. Then there's big windows here. And there is a big arch. Okay. Or maybe these windows are small. Maybe the windows are smaller and the arches. Somewhere there's an arch. Is that here? Yeah, see this arch? That's what I'm trying to. This right here. This arch. This situation is what I'm trying to get. Or decide that I'm gonna put there. Okay, so. Stained glass stuff, whatever. Stuff with the things. Head table. Big throne. Table. Then we have the 8 tables that come out, right? So, if they are this big here, if somebody was walking, oh, and there's stairs too, I forgot. Stairs. Come to about the edge like that. Which is what they do in front of the palace too, so actually this works out. Alright, looks pretty legit so far. It's a lot of guessing. It's not a lot of guess, it's a little bit of guessing. It's a little bit of knowing, it's a little bit of guessing. So if those are the stairs, then the tables probably start around here. Here's my vanishing point. This is the center. interesting. Okay, I'm gonna use my ruler actually so I don't have just a ton of lines everywhere. So, through center. I think that's too long. Really good. And I think it's too big, which is okay. I'm gonna say like that, probably. Okay, and I'm just gonna make some more tables. Boring, but cool, kind of. Again, I know it's a rough sketch, but I just want to make sure I have an idea of where the perspective is supposed to be for it. I'm right to it. I just want to know. Right on the salt. Where should I go? But again, all this, it kind of almost doesn't even matter because your focal point is going to be, so we have the stage. Or I think I did it like, yeah, it's like two round platforms. And they also have like these cool like, the mirrors. I don't know if they're in this picture. They're definitely in a picture. Yeah, these like floating chandeliers. Let me steal one of these. I'm just doing quick screen captures and some reminders. Big. If I continue, if I use my ruler, continue this line, they will line up, right? Not quite. Oh, no, I did. I think I did. I lined up it around the top and then hang down off the ceiling. So I think it's mostly right. You know, it's not a hard science. I'm not an alchemist like Vanessa. Are elaborately decorated tables that I will deal with. Nah. There's eight. I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not enough. Oh, that is not tight enough. Boring, boring, boring. But kind of cool. But kind of boring. But you're getting some of the pot. Table. I should think they're still too close together because people gotta know. feel like it's wrong. Something's wrong. If I move him down. Oh, it's just like, yeah. Oh, windows and stuff. I just want to make sure I remember that there's stuff back here when I draw it. I don't know what exactly it's going to be yet. Also, this is on a curve. So anyway, we've got musicians, so they're about that high. Look at these tables, again, like this. We have lots of pillars. And musicians, maybe there's like three, maybe here. So then, those are the musicians. If somebody's standing here, they're about this high. Alright, if somebody's standing here. And there's the other folks out here. I'm not sure from a perspective standpoint if that's correct. If she is here. I think this is right though. To draw people dancing, that's gonna have to be a reference. But I do want to make sure they're the right size. Move all of this down a little. Just a little. my goodness. This is almost 2.5 hours. I wasn't joking when I said I started this on leap year, or leap day, this year, February 29th. And I think next February 29th is when I might have this whole thing close to complete. But I do just want to say that I will intend on posting oh, that's nice. Thank you. I hope you're enjoying your work day. What was I saying? Oh, so I'm hoping to post this to Webtoon next Valentine's Day. Which is, I'm sure, what all romance people are planning on doing, but... I don't know why I keep putting the people in the foreground and shit, I don't know, but I am. Thank you. And I'm sorry I didn't see it. I had a bunch of screens up blocking my stuff. So, but thank you. Thank you for dropping in. Thank you for checking it out. Thank you for hitting me up in the chat. I do interact, though. Dance, monkey dance. No, not like that, but alright. Back to my story. I do have a chunk of more. Oh yeah, they have a whole section of dialogue where these two just, they start fighting right away. Ugh, he smells good too. That's what that says. That's funny. So, he says, you know. I'm thrilled to see you again. As you must be to see me. I think I want to turn them just because he... Out of curiosity, so if you're at work and you think this is inspiring, are you an artist? Is that why you're inspired? Is your work art? Do you wish your work was art? A father's gaming challenge? I want to know. Let me know. When you get a chance. No pressure. Yeah, so I turned them because he starts talking first and it'll make it easier if his dialogue bubbles are on the same side as him. At least in theory, so let me get some of these scribbles on the left. I mean, sloppy is sloppy, but it's like a little too sloppy. So. He looks so tall. He's not that... I mean, he's taller than her, but not by, like... Also draw long necks. Come on. Now your weaknesses. Alright, so he's like, I'm thrilled to see you again. She's like, that makes one of us. It's like, I feel like we got on the wrong foot. Yeah. Totally. For real? Of course we got up on the wrong foot. And then she's like, you can't take no for an answer, which is true. He's very persistent. I like that line, but it doesn't make sense though here. I'm gonna think about it. We didn't get off on any foot. I like that we didn't get off on any foot. Take a hint? Oh no, because it. Because he's like, oh, I just want you to know what you're saying too. He just can't take no for an answer. He's like, I want you to know what you're saying no to. And, you know, she's right. Before you say no, you should know what you're saying no to. Now, to be fair, maybe she doesn't care what she's saying no to. So, he's gonna move up. Again, I'm doing this for just spacing. This is an important piece, and I want to make sure there's room for it. Might not need the knot at all. Yeah. It cleans it up. And to be fair, if you know what he's thinking, they did get off on the wrong foot. He had a different plan for this. He didn't mean for it to go badly. I don't think he was, he's one of those people that hasn't heard no a lot. So he wasn't ready to hear it. Sure. Because I want them to be like kind of going tit for tat visually. Maybe it does have to go like in front of them like that. That feels pretty good. Before I delete all my art, let me lasso this out. Let's see. Let's see. That's way too big. I mean, he gave her a pretty good deal. Hey. Come work with me. But, you know, she knows too much. She's seen too much. She thinks, I don't trust this guy. I I don't like that I'm encroaching on, whoops, on their dancing, on the dancing like part, but I also, the dialogue is kind of more important. She's gonna have a little high roll thing, like, ugh. He smells good too. All right, that's some progress. All right, now what? Again, this entire sequence, I'm so happy to see it visually. I had it, like, timing-wise in my head, but not, like, comic book-wise, and so it was just kind of fun. I mean, I'm sure it could be better with somebody with more comic experience, but I like how it turned out. It's fun. Eraser bigger. Annoying. Yeah, their tit for tat is really something else. I'll say that for sure. Alright, let's lock in their dialogue. Okay. I mostly do it so I can, like, select and, like, move stuff if I want to. Again, this is not the final in any way. This is just the layout, so it can be really sloppy to look, I think. I'm not passing it off to anybody. I'm doing all the art myself. So if I was passing off to somebody, I would tighten this up for sure. Just saying. This would not be it. Okay. I've got about 20 minutes here. I think I can still do some more hands. I do think we need still just a little bit more space here. Just to transition out of the ballroom. This is going to be a some sort of gradient. I don't know how I'm going to do the tiles. The tiles are going to be fancy. I don't know yet. They'll be fancy though. I think my reference needs to move. And so. This? Yeah, because I want the tiles. Let me see. Something to be like diamonds or something. I don't like this. We'll do this kind of thing. Cool tiles. There's a ruler. Ooh, wow. Elven Bank Hall. It's amazing. I think that would look really cool. I'll deal with that later, but there's gonna be like cool tiles, there's gonna be more floor like under her, it's not gonna end as abruptly. I'll go over here. It'll just be the end of the panel. Yeah. So more dance floor. Don't show a lot of the sun, or not the sun, the this big dome. The elaborate whatever is my official name for it. It's my world, I'll do what I want. notes are rough, but like, let's finish off his hair and stuff. There we go. Better. Alright, so then it goes on to, she points out, he, how much more script is here? Oh, okay. Alright. So she, so I'm through, if we're looking at the script vertically, okay, which I mean, I'm looking at a word processor document I made, and where I'm at right now, is that half? I'm about halfway, script-wise. There's less drawing, maybe? I'm not sure how long it'll take. Okay. She gets into the business, which is that he forged the marriage documents. So maybe she just straight says it. It's like a close-up on her. So she's mad, like I said. Oh, this is also one of my favorite lines. She's like, is that why you forged our marriage documents? And he's like, forge is a strong word. I expedited them. Like, this is definitely happening. Which, spoiler alert, it is. But listen, that's not really a spoiler. Because like I said, if you are reading a romance comic called The Alchemist Bride and you don't think the two leads are eventually going to end up together, then you haven't. Then I don't know. Then I don't know what you're waiting for. That's kind of the whole point. Oh, she just has some more internal dialogue. Here. So she really puts it out there. But she's like, enough. Is that why you forged our marriage documents? And I think this forged right here. I don't have bold, but if I did, it would be. I don't know if I'll do this in the final, but it's really important. So she's gonna emphasize it. And I'm not doing typesetting per se, but I do want to know the flow. This might be too high. So let's move this down. She says it. Again, she's not trying to make a scene. But like, hey, is that how you did it? This is so much easier. I mean, if I was doing this in pencil, I'd be like erasing or cutting and taping. Like, I mean, yeah, the computer is so nice. But like I said, I'm used to doing traditional comics, and not only that, but I, the vertical format's new for me too, so I'm trying to figure out how the vertical formats flow. Gaming challenge looks familiar to me. Forgive me. Like I said, it's been like not an entire year, but a long time, and I feel like I've definitely seen you before. So thanks for coming back. Just want to acknowledge that I've probably seen you before, and I feel like we definitely. I'm gonna try to figure out. Why remember you? I mean, I'm trying to think. You like traditional comics, I think. And forgive me if you are not the individual. I mean, and lots of people do, but it might be you who I went on talking about. Okay. Oh, good at that. If you've never been here before, welcome. If you've been here before and I don't remember you, I apologize and thank you even more. So he's like... This music sounds intense. Like I said, it's quieter for me. I don't hear it as much, but my goodness. This might be my last panel for the day, sadly. Thank you. merging layers again. I'm not sure. Maybe like over on the front of here. Or not a vertical, a diagonal. So. Space. She's got some internal dialogue, like a little, her little bubble's gonna come back up. So smug. I think I'm good. That's where I'm gonna end it. That's a good place to stop. Like I said, there's a lot more comic to this. I'm probably only halfway. Figuring out the palace, and some of this took like a little longer than I would have expected, but I do like how it's turning out. Yeah. Alchemist Bride is definitely underway. The experiment continues next week. Thank you for joining me. Father's Gaming Challenge. Have a good day at work and a good rest of your week. Thanks for everybody else who lurked, or if you stopped by and said hi, or if you're watching this after, hello. It will be on YouTube later today. So, yeah. See you on the next one. Thanks.